story we'd like to share before we go. See, here on the avenue of Avenue Q, we believe in freedom. Freedom of speech, freedom of expression, freedom to be whoever the hell you want to be. What better place to express that freedom but in your own bedroom? So we want to encourage you to do what you want, to who you want, how you want, but most importantly, we want you to be loud. You can be as loud as the hell you want when you're making love.
When you're making love.
You can be as loud as the hell you want when you're making love. Neighbors doing what?
And
did you not just hear what we were singing about? Go on, y'all. Keep on doing what you're doing. You're not bothering anybody. But remember, be loud. No, we need you to be
louder.
You're not allowed to be loud at the library, at the art museum, or at the playground. We do at your party,
I'm doing the nasty.
Don't behave like you're at the ballet.
Between a lover and a friend, there's a fine, fine line between reality and pretend. And you never know till you reach the top if it was worth the uphill climb. There's a fine, fine line between love and a waste of time. There's a fine, fine line between a fairy tale and a lie. There's a fine, fine line between you're wonderful and goodbye. I guess if someone doesn't love you back, it isn't such a crime. Between together and not. There's a fine, fine line between what you wanted and what you got. Yeah. and a waste of time.
An afternoon alone with my favorite book, Broadway musicals of the 1940s. No roommate to bother me. How can it get any better than this?
Oh, hi, Rod!
Hi, Nikki.
Oh, hey, Rod. You'll never guess what happened to me on the subway this morning. Well, this guy was smiling at me and talking to me.
That's very interesting.
Mm-hmm. He was being real friendly. And you know, I think he was coming on to me. Well, I think he might have thought I was gay.
So why are you telling me this? Why should I care? I don't care. What did you have for lunch today?
Well, Rod, there's no need to get all defensive.
I'm not getting defensive. What do I care about some gay guy you met? I am trying to read.
Well, I didn't mean anything by it, Rod. Well, I just think it's something that we should be able to talk about.
Well, I don't want to talk about it, Nikki. This conversation is over.
Well, well, okay. But just so you know, if you were gay, that'd be okay. I mean, 'cause hey, I'd like you anyway. Because you see, if it were me, I would feel free to say that I was gay, but I'm not gay.
Nikki, please, I am trying to read. What?
If you were queer,
Nikki,
I'd still be here.
Nikki, please, I'm trying to read this book.
Year after year.
Nikki!
Because you're dear to me. And I know that you.
What?
Would accept me too.
Oh, I would.
If I told you today.
Hey, guess what? I'm gay.
But I'm not gay. I'm happy just being with you.
Oh, my button shoes is now, Joey.
So what's the matter to me? What you do in bed with guys?
Nikki, that is gross.
No, it's not. If you